king. And said, king. The king said, what? They said, we saw three boys defying your decree to bow down.
Yeah.
Come on.
And the king said, they heard what I said.
Yes, sir.
Because I heard myself say.
Yeah.
So you need to tell me they heard my decree and disobeyed what I said. Yes, sir.
Right.
King, we're here to report that they weren't doing what they were supposed to do. Richmond is drastically different than Rock Hill.
Yeah. Right.
You gotta be drastically different. Right. Because see, in Richmond, and more intimately in New Covenant, you don't have people that are so involved, engulfed, and interested in your business.
Really?
And your business.
Really?
And your business.
Really?
And your business.
Really?
That they're not even tending to their own business.
Yeah.
Let me give you a three-word sermon that you can preach any time of the year. You can preach this sermon for the rest of your life.
Yeah.
It's going to make you sleep better. It's going to make you praise harder. It's going to open up doors in your life. You're going to look younger. God going to add years to your life. If you just learn and are willing to preach this one sermon, do you want to preach the sermon? I need you to look at somebody and tell them, God said, mind your business. Go ahead and preach it to somebody else. Mind your business. Don't worry about how I got the car. Mind your business. Don't worry about how I got married. Mind your business. Oh, messy shouting. You know what messy shouting is? Always wondering how they get daddy.
Yeah.
How she accomplished daddy. How he achieved it. He shouted. Well, the stories alone as astrologers. They were into astrology, the study of the sun and the moon, the stars. Here's my thing. If the Chaldeans were astrologers, and everything that they were assigned to and interested in was up here.
What are you doing here?
Right.
Yeah. Right. Yeah.
How?
Yeah. What are you doing there?
In the ham sandwich.
Yeah.
Were they able to see what the Hebrew boys were doing down there?
Yeah.
See, this is what you gotta understand.
Right.
See, real posture of worship is not.
Right. Right.
This is nice, but this isn't a true form and posture of worship. A true form and posture of worship is when you lay down with your head to the ground, with your hands extended out in deference and honor to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Now, Nebuchadnezzar said, when the music played, I need everybody to worship the golden image that I created. Now, everybody, according to Dr. Webster's dictionary, means everybody. So if everybody was supposed to be worshiping,
somebody, mind your business.
If you want this next year of ministry to move in favor of God, you've got to commit yourself to minding your business and leaving other folks folk can't even bring a date to church because y'all get the text and tweet and talk. And if you mind your business, God will send you a Boaz. Maybe if you mind your business, God will give you a queen for your life. These old messy Chaldeans were so concerned with what the Hebrew boys weren't doing that I would venture to say they weren't doing it themselves. That's how you know when God has you in the pipeline for promotion, when you've got to deal with messy people. And not only will you have to deal with messy people, Pastor, but I know you've had your fair share of messy people, but you also then have to experience man's persecution. Nebuchadnezzar said, how dare they disobey my decree? Bring them to me. Bring them to me. And I know the story that they arrived in the presence of the king. And the king said, please tell me that what the Chaldeans reported was incorrect. At that moment, these boys had the opportunity of a lifetime to change their story and to fall in line with what the king expected.
Right.
But Pastor, in this second year of your pastorate, this is the year that you cannot fall victim to convenience.
That's right.
Don't make convenient decisions.
That's right.
God anointed you to make the uncomfortable decision. Well, don't make the decision that's popular. Make the decision that's purposeful. And if they don't like it, if they don't agree with it, if they stop coming, that's between them and God. But as long as you stand on what you believe in and do what God called you to do, God will protect you. Don't you dare lower your standards.
That's right.
Just to be accepted.
That's
right. Don't you dare get me down who you are. Just to be connected. You gotta hang out with folk and you're telling jokes that ain't even funny. They're talking about stories that's outdated. And you frustrated and irritated because you're trying to move to another level and they want to stay stuck where they are. This year of your life, you better learn how to blow up some deuces and turn every stagnant and small-minded person. It was fun while it lasted, but I got to go where God is leading me. I dare you to tell somebody, this is your year to make the hard decision. These boys, I'm almost through here. These boys had to make a hard decision. What I call a destiny decision. They said, yeah, King, we didn't bow. No, Mr. King, we didn't worship your golden god. We will only worship the God of Abraham. The God of us. And the God of Jacob. Don't let nobody stop you from praising your God. If you sit on a row and some demonic praise police try to control the flow of the row, don't you move. You praise God until they move. I'm tired of preachers talking about check your row, and if they ain't praising God on your row, then move now, man. I got power. Why should I have to move? I'm going to let my praise flow. And if they don't like it, they need to get out of the presence of praise. Brother Nick, I ain't going nowhere. Act funny with me if you want to. I'm going to be here next Saturday. You can talk about me all week long. I'm going to be shouting next Saturday. I'll be in the same room, in the same service, in the same spirit. I shall not be moved. Here they are now. About to feel the pain of man's persecution. Nebuchadnezzar told his men, light up the furnace.